Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. My name is Sandra Solomon and you have found my channel where I have fragrance fun. And today I have Rotten Rebel with me.
Hi guys.
So if you haven't already done that, you should really check his channel.
Channel.
Please. I'm new to this. Yep. So he has tons of great contents for men and women. If you go there, you might not return here again. But
no,
I hope you
they're gonna come back, yeah.
Yeah. So we are going to go through 10 cheapies for men.
Mm, nice.
And you are going to tell us about them, and I am going to get my impression of them and also rate them for you.
Cool.
So you know if it's worth spending your money, even if these are cheaper than most.
Mm.
Yeah.
Let's do this.
So let's start.
Yeah.
So first up, we have Bentley for Men Azure. And this is one that I think you have had for quite a while.
I can't remember if I had it maybe 2 years max. But this one to me is like a freshy, a budget freshy. Now Bentley makes amazing fragrances quite cheap, and this one is no exception. So this one is sort of an aquatic, but with a twist. To me, this is a really smooth one, and if you are bored with sort of a standard freshes that are full of citrus, then I think you are going to enjoy this one. I can't remember if it has something pineapple or something sweet in it.
Okay.
But I really enjoy it, and for the price I think every single man should get it.
Yeah, and I do pick up on that there is something fruity in it. Mm. And it's aquatic and fresh at the same
yeah.
time, and I really enjoy this one, and it does have that Bentley for Men DNA.
Mm.
So you really recognize it from Bentley for Men and Bentley for Men Intense. You can tell that
it's quality.
It's quality. Yeah. So I think this is pretty good for being a cheapie. So on a scale from 1 to 5, I am going to give this a 3.
Mm. Pretty good then.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
So next up is one that I have the female version of, and that one I really, really love.
Mm.
So this is Darej Pour Homme.
Mm.
Yeah. So what do you think of this one?
Mm. To me, this is like something sweet. I do pick up something floral-ish, but I don't know what it is. And don't be scared, guys or women. It's not too heavy on any florals, but I can't pick up all the notes actually, so I don't know exactly what's in it, but it's something sweet. I wouldn't say it's fresh, but it's dirt cheap. I think you can find it like sub 20 bucks, so it's going to be cheaper than 20 bucks.
Yeah.
Really well made. I love putting it on, and I love using it for layering as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I think this is really good. It's sweet. It's as you said, and I also think it's a little bit fruity.
Mm.
I can't pick up any of the notes either, but I like this really much, and I think that you get a very good fragrance for the money.
Yeah, definitely.
This is really impressive. I don't understand how they can make this so cheap.
Yeah.
So rating this for being a cheapie, I think it's a 4.
Mm. And I just want to add that this one has pretty solid performance as well. And so did actually Bentley Azure. That one has above average performance. So really, these are like a no-brainers, according to at least me.
Yeah, I agree.
Cool.
Moving on to, at least for me, new one, but I'm guessing this has been out there for a while.
Yeah.
And this is Nautica Voyage. So what do you think of this one?
So this one to me is a really smooth and well-made aquatic fragrance, and I really think that it smells more expensive than it is. This one was, I believe, like 15 or 18 bucks, so really, really cheap.
Yeah.
And I actually heard online like stories that it was really good, so I just decided to try it out, and it indeed is a really good one. It just smells fresh, nice, bright, aquatic, and I believe that this one is something that you simply cannot go wrong with.
No.
Use it summertime or when you are going on a beach vacation or anything like that, and you are going to smell amazing. Yeah. And since it's so cheap, you can spray it on as much as you want. Spray it on before the pool, and when you get up, you spray it on again. And when you come up from the beach, you spray it on again and again and again.
Yeah.
And you will smell amazing.
Yeah. And I do agree, this really smells more expensive than it is. Mm. I actually don't think that aquatics are so sexy, but this is actually a sexy aquatic. And
it's
I
like
think it's
fresh
because
and
it's
nice.
So smooth.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's so rounded in some way.
Yeah.
I would really enjoy this on a man on a date. Mm. I think it's a perfect date fragrance.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Imagine you are going on a date with a man during a warm summer evening or something.
Yes.
And you get a whiff of something that is like this, fresh,
yeah.
Nice, clean.
That
I mean,
would be
who
really
doesn't
good.
Like that?
Yeah.
So yeah, I really love Nautica Voyage, and for the price, it's a steal.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about?
I'm gonna go ahead and give this a 4.5. I think it's almost perfect. It's so
cool.
Much for a good fragrance for the money. It's a
yeah.
Really good cheapie.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So moving on to the next. And the next one is the one that I was actually surprised about how much I liked.
Mm.
So it's CK1 Shock. So what do you think of this one?
I bought this, like, I believe I bought it in an airport. They had a deal on it. I believe that's a 200 mil. And
yeah.
I bought it like way back in 2011 or 2010.
Whoa, this bottle?
Yeah, the same bottle.
Wow.
So
it's 10 years old
yeah,
now.
Yeah,
that's
I haven't
cool.
Finished it. But what can I say? I think that this one, the moment I smelled it, I knew that this one would be a compliment getter, and I was right. This one, I think every single man and woman I met enjoy this one. I never heard anything bad about it. It smells a lot more expensive than it is. And in my, according to me, this is probably the best sort of a cheapie from Calvin Klein.
Yeah,
I just love this one.
And I mean, we can
spicy,
just
spicy, sweet. It has a mix of everything: a hint of tobacco, a hint of something that is leatherish, but it's just tucked in under the rest of the notes.
Yes.
This is like a really budget-friendly spice bomb, but not spice bomb.
Yeah, I agree.
It's really nice.
And we can just conclude that if you can buy this cheap and it lasts for 10 years and still smelling good, I mean, this is quality. It's really good.
Yeah, I would say though, if you only own this, then you're probably gonna, it's not gonna last you 10 years.
Yeah.
This is just because I'm a frag addict, that's the reason why this has lasted so long.
Yeah.
But, I mean, here's the thing, I would love to use this way more often if the performance was a bit better.
Yeah.
But since it's so cheap, it's just, you don't have to care about it. Just spray it on, carry an atomizer with you so you can reapply, and you are going to smell so damn good for so little money. So this is another no-brainer, at least to me. How do you feel about it?
No, I really like it. I think it's incredible. And I did mean that if it can be in this bottle for 10 years and still smell good
when
I try it 10 years later, it's really good quality.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm actually going to give this a 5.
Whoa.
So it's a top rating.
Nice.
I think it's really good, and I am surprised.
Cool, the first top rated one in this list. Nice.
Next up, we have another classic, and that is Boss Bottle from Hugo. Hugo Boss.
Hugo Boss.
Yeah. So, what do you think of this one?
I mean, it's one of the world's most famous, and it's a best seller, and I call it a modern classic because it is.
Yeah.
Almost every single man owns it or have heard about it or know someone who owns it. I believe my dad has one, I have one, some of my friends have one, and pretty much every single, at least woman and man, love it. It has that sort of, I believe it's an apple note together with something sweet. I believe there's cinnamon in it as well, and a bunch of other notes. that you usually can't go wrong with this one. Most people like it. And I mean, there's a reason why still in 2021, when you go to airports, you are still going to find big signs that screams at you, you go boss and now deal for this and this and this. Yeah. It's because most people like it. It's a mass appealing, cheapy, and I really enjoy it.
So I do think this is good. I mean, I'm like most people. And it does smell great, and it's a really, really good cheapie. So this is going to get a high rating.
Mm.
But if you are going to spend your money on a cheapie, I think you should go with one of the others that is more more unique, like the Voyage one or some else, because you don't want to smell like the rest of the crowd. You want to smell different.
True.
So I am giving this a 4, but it's a 4, but not a recommendation to buy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Go with one of the others.
Okay.
Next up, we have CK1. So this is the original.
Yeah.
And we already tried the Flanker Shock.
Yeah, yeah.
So what do you think of this one?
You
have used quite a lot of the bottle, but you might have had it for a long
time. Yeah, I had this one. This one has been with me for quite some time during my fragrance journey. CK1 is a classic. It's a unisex one. It's done by Alberto Morillas, which is one of my favorite perfumers. I really love it, but it's, I mean, the performance is not the best one. And I mean, to me, this one has a sort of a fresh vibe to it, but it's not overly heavy on the citrus, so it's pretty in the middle there. It has a sort of a aquatic vibe, but it's not an aquatic either.
No.
So it has something unique going on. But the thing is with CK1 is I don't think that it has enough personality.
No, I was just about to say that I think this is boring. Yeah.
So it's one of those that it's so cheap. You can usually find 200 mil for like dirt cheap. And when people get away from it, most are going to think that you smell pleasant. But in my experience, not everyone are going to be like, wow. Did you smell that guy or woman? I mean, that's not the effect you get. But it's so cheap, you can bring it on when you're going to vacation and just overspray it and you're gonna smell good.
So, no. This is cheap and it definitely doesn't smell bad, but I think it's so boring. I wouldn't enjoy this on a man. It's like, this is like you smell when you have fresh clothes on. And it's nothing more special than that. So I'm not saying it's bad, but you're wasting your money, even though it's a cheapie. So I think you should go with one of the others. Yeah.
Okay.
Next up, we have another one that has just recently become one of my favorites. And it's you who introduced me to it. I didn't know it existed. So this is Mont Blanc Individuel. What do you think of it?
To me, this smells like a mix of a perfume with something that reminds me of something that you like, a laundry detergent or like a sort of a fabric softener or something along those lines. So this one has a ton of notes, but it has something like a fruity berry side to it, which I enjoy. And then it has something, at least on my skin, this one goes a bit to the in the soapy direction, which you either love or hate. I don't enjoy overly soapy fragrances, but this one is really, really nice. And I do enjoy that it's a combination of something fresh, but something slightly sweet, but that sweetness is not too heavy in any way. I really enjoy it. It's like a no-brainer. If I want to smell fresh and nice, I just spray it on and then I go out. And I believe most people are going to enjoy it.
Yeah, and I really agree with you. Not on the softener, maybe a little bit. But it is a really fresh and good one, but with spices and sweetness that makes it more of it feels more exclusive than it is. So this is definitely one I think you should spend money on.
And to me, at least on my skin, this is actually pretty decent, above average when it comes to the performance.
Okay.
And it was, I believe I paid like 22 or 25 bucks for it, which means that it's going to be, it's like a really cheap one.
Yeah.
And highly recommended. I think this one smells more expensive than it actually is.
So I'm going to give this a 4. It's a really good one.
Nice.
So moving on to the next one, and this is one that is not the cheapest one, but you usually can find it at a quite a good price.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's Versace Pour Homme. So what do you think of this one?
So Versace Pour Homme, I can't remember all the different notes in it, but to me it's light, it's bright, it's oh so smooth.
Yeah.
I think it has a bit of musk at the base together with woody notes. And I really, really enjoy it. This is like another no-brainer. You spray it on and you are going to have something like a fresh, nice, clean and manly vibe around you. It's not that insane when it comes to the sillage, so you need to overspray it in order for other people to notice it. But it just, it smells so, I mean, this is not a complicated scent. It just smells nice and clean. And a lot of people enjoy scents like that. So I've had quite a lot of positive reactions, especially from women, when I've had this one on. But I just gotta remind you guys, when I get reactions is when I overspray it. If I just do like 1, 2, 3, 4, it's gonna be gone in like an hour or two.
Yeah.
So overspray it and you will get compliments, period.
Yeah, and I think that you used the term bright to describe it, and that's just the perfect word for it. It's really bright. It's the perfect summer fragrance. But I would actually think this is, you can wear it all year round. What do you think?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so I think I'm gonna give this a 4. So it's a good one.
Pretty good.
Yeah. So next up we have John Varvatos Vintage.
Yeah.
And you have several from John Varvatos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this one to me smells sort of mature, if you will. Smells, there's something about it that I really, really love. So you can pick up the rhubarb, which is quite prominent. And then you have tucked underneath, you have a bit of leather, a bit of tobacco, but those are sort of really tucked behind the rest of the notes. You have some sweetness to it. There are a ton of notes in this one.
Yeah, and spices, I guess, because it's spicy and good.
And definitely lavender as well. So this to me smells something that is classic and manly, in a sort of a, not vintage, but a bit old schoolish.
Yeah.
I love it, but I'm gonna give a straight up honest tip to you guys. Not every woman will enjoy this one on you. In my experience, it's about 50-50. 50% of the women you are going to meet up with when you have this one on are going to think that you smell pretty damn good. The rest are going to think that you smell a bit old man-ish. That's the way it is.
Okay.
And so that's like a buyer beware. Don't buy this one if you want something that is sort of a really modern and all that stuff. And don't buy this if you want something that is truly mass appealing. Sure, a lot of women are going to enjoy that one on you, but there are those that are going to think that you smell a bit like an old man. But I love it.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
Yes, I am torn between liking it and thinking it smells old man-ish.
Okay.
And I actually think I have this one.
Ah.
And I'm starting to wonder why I bought it, because I don't think I would use it.
Okay.
I mean,
no, it's
me
not good
smelling
if you,
like an old
yeah,
man.
That's not,
yeah, no,
yeah,
that's not good.
That.
So I guess I'm going to have to find someone to give it to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so,
What are you going to give it then?
I would say like this, you probably get a good fragrance for the money because it is a cheapie.
Yeah.
You have to be cautious, just like Rotten Rebel said.
Yeah.
But if you are, if you know that the woman you are with or dating is one that these kind of fragrances. Yeah. You should go with this one.
And because if you really, it's a really enjoy good the one. Notes, then yeah.
Yeah. So my rating is highly subjective. So this is a 3 out of 5 for me.
Okay.
So I think we are finishing off with the one that is, I think, the best of all of these. And that is Club de Nuit Intense Man.
Yeah.
And I think you might agree with me on that
one. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, this one, what can I say? I think it's enough that I say that this one recently appeared on my 15 fragrances that I just can't live without.
Yeah, I can put a link to that in the description.
I just love this one. So this one, in a nutshell, is a clone of Aventus, Creed Aventus. And it's just one of those that simply works. And when I say works, I mean that a ton of women, like a majority, are going to think that you smell awesome. And when I say awesome, I mean like, insanely sexy and manly. It's insane what this one does. It is truly insane. And I can highly recommend it if you want a super cheapy that is going to be mass appealing and a monster when it comes to compliments. This one is crazy.
And to performance also, I guess.
Yeah, the performance is really, really good.
Yeah. I really enjoy this on a man. I think it's you get so much fragrance for the money. It's so cheap and it's so good. And I can agree with you that I think every woman will like it. And you actually have experienced it. So
yeah.
We already got to know that. Of course, a 5.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, if you are going to pick 3 out of these cheapies that you think that a man should spend his money on, which 3 are you going to choose?
Good question. So my first recommendation is Club de Nuit Man Intense from Armuff. This one, usually you can find it really cheap. And I was not kidding when I said that this one is a monster. When it comes to compliments, it's the performance is really, really good. You can usually find it like below $30.
Wow.
So this one is a no-brainer. Just get it. And this one is the one that I prefer the most out of these ones. On the number 2 place, I'm gonna put CK1 Shock because it smells amazing. And once again, you can find it really, really cheap. Sure, the performance is like average. But I mean, just get the biggest bottle and overspray and carry an atomizer with you and you're going to be fine. It smells so damn good. On number 3, so what we have here is something sort of woody and slightly sweet. And then we have this one, which is sweet, tobacco-ish, spicy. So we have different characters to them. So I wanted to balance things up with Nautica Voyage, which is a freshie that smells way more expensive than it is.
Yeah.
So if you would get like these 3, you're gonna have 3 different sort of scents. One that you can use summertime, one that you can use all year round. And in my world, you can use CK1 Shock as well during the summer, but this one would be perfect winter time. But honorable sort of a mention in this one is Montblanc Individuel. This one is so nice. And it is a bit more expensive than Nautica Voyage, but if you prefer another kind of scent that is fresh but not aquatic like this one, then go for Individuel. So these three are my top picks with an honorable mention of Montblanc Individuel.
Yeah, and that's a really good pick, I think. I think I agree with you. I'm not sure if there's anyone else I would add. Yeah, I would add the Dorage Pour Homme. But I don't know which one I would switch it for. So guys, you can go wrong with some of these, according to me. Not these. Some of the ones we tried, like CK1, I don't think you should buy that one. But if you go with any of these 4, you can't go wrong. You will smell good and you won't be broke.
No.
So, of course, we would like you to like this video.
Yeah, come on, like
we would
it.
Be
you
very happy if you also subscribe to our channels. I will put a link to Rotten Rebels channel in the description, and we want to see you here again. So I wish to see you next time. Bye.
Bye.